My name is Makea Joseph Wakatini Ariki. I am one of the one Ariki with the other two Ariki, which is Makea Karika, Makea Nui. But my title was Wakatini, Makea Wakatini Ariki. I am one of the great sons of the Makea Pini, which we are going to see later on the top of the mountain. I think it's been hidden or never been seen by anyone, even though most of the people living on this village heard the name, but never seen it. In 1973, I was taken up there to see this stone of the hill. The reason is, the son of one of the Mataibu took me up because he wanted to show me this particular carving stone on the mountain. I don't know what the reason is. He'd been ordered by his father, which is one of the Mataibu on our bridge, the Maiwa Mataibu, to take me up there to see this particular stone being carved. It's part of our great chief, Makea Pini. Therefore, I went with him, just the two of us. And on the way up, he was telling me about the story about this particular rock on the top of a mountain. So I went with him and on the way. And he say like this, Makea Pini is one of the great chief of Te Rua.
So he didn't allow us to come up here. He thought the place was haunted.
But the way he said is the great admired by a lot of women. So I said to myself, oh my gee, I was at time. And I'll be happy to be him. So I was lucky. I went up with him to see this particular carved stone on the hill. So we went. This is the story he told me. When he died, this great chief of the Rarotonga, they all moaned and they cried and cried. Then they called their warriors. They wanted to see the warrior.
You've had your lesson on the candle nut.
Yeah.
The old candles in the old days.
If they can do something to carve, to remember him by all his lovers or admirers. So I went up. And he keep on telling me, they went up and carved this particular rock like a penis, like Makea Pini penis.
This is a sign of rocks or boulders that have been placed there. It's an indication of the village. You're entering into the village or the marae.
But when they finish, they look at it, it's too huge, too big. Oh my God, they can't carry them down. So one of them decided to carve a small one.
I've been up Iguru twice. And the Manga once. This one, I just come under. I didn't climb to the top.
And how old are you again?
88.
88.
Very good age.
Yes, very good age.
I'm 76.
And they all moaned and cried, and they asked the warrior to take it away and hide them. But the warrior didn't take away, hide them. The warrior took them up, pulled them up, and turned the top into the ground and hide the top. Now, everybody can go have a look now. You can see, they can't see the top. It's in the ground. You only see half of it, which is the, we call it the tumu or the uara. That's our Maori way of talking about this thing. So that's the story of the great chief of our great-grandfather, Makea Pini himself.
I think this will be my last. Now that's why I had to come up with a camera. So to prove whoever going to watch this document. Here we are. Romana.
Mm-hmm.